Hi everyone, welcome to eStudy.in. So in this video we will learn what are tokens, keywords, identifiers, literals and punctuators. So let us understand the meaning of these terms. Okay, so let's start. We have a program here, okay, and through this program what we'll do is, so we'll understand the meaning of identifiers and literals through this program. So now we have written a program class test and we have a sum method or a sum function. And here we are taking two variables a and b, and we have written int. Okay, int a is equal to 2 comma b is equal to 3 followed by semicolon. So as I told you, semicolon is a statement terminator. Now similarly, we have taken another variable int c and a semicolon. Now what is a variable? That we will understand in a little while. For the time being, let us understand what are identifiers. So what are identifiers? Identifiers are the names which we can give to the class. For example, test. So test is an identifier. Sum, it is also an identifier because it is the name of the method. A, B, C. So these are the names of the variables. So A, B, C, these are identifiers. So identifiers are basically the names which are given to a method, to a class or to a variable. Okay, now what are literals? Literals are the values. For example, 3, 2. So these are literals. So these are numbers, integer values. Similarly, if you have a string, that means whatever is written in double quotes and we have more than one character, 0 and more than one character, it is a string. Okay, string is basically a combination of characters. So when you put something in double quotes and so that becomes a string. So this is again a string literal. This is an integer literal. This is a like a decimal literal, we can say, because we have 12.4. And when you write something, a single character in single quotes, it is a character literal. So basically a character is any one character enclosed in single quotes. Okay, so basically different types of literals are there, but we will not get into that right now. So as of now, literal is basically a constant value which cannot be changed. So 2, 3, C, 12.4, anu, these are some of the literals. Now moving on, so we've understood what is an identifier, what is a literal. Now we understand what is a keyword. Now keyword, if you see here, class is a keyword, class. Public is a keyword, void is a keyword, int is a keyword, system is a keyword, out is a keyword, println is a keyword. So these keywords, that means what we understand is the keywords are something which are provided to us by the language. That means these are given to us by Java language. So we cannot use them in whichever way we want. We have to use them as they are provided to us. So as I told you earlier, if class is a keyword, so I have to write class in a small letters. I cannot write class. So I cannot write class with C capital because it is a keyword and it is provided to us by Java. So Java says that you have to write it in small letters. Similarly, public, you cannot write P capital, but then it will not be a keyword. Similarly, system, S has to be capital. If you write S small, it will be an error. Okay. So these are the keywords which are provided to us by the language. Now what are punctuators? Now if you see, we have a semicolon here, we have a comma which is separating two variables. Okay, so these are some of the punctuators: comma, semicolon, round brackets, curly brackets and dot. If you see, we have a dot here. So these are some of the punctuators. Okay, now what are tokens? So basically token is when you combine everything: keyword, identifier, literals, punctuators, operators, these combined will be tokens. And operators, we all know, operators plus, minus. Now in Java, the multiplication symbol is this asterisk symbol, okay, the star, okay, right? And this is a symbol for division in Java. And modulus, this is another operator which we will study later, okay? So these are some of the operators which are there in Java. Now let's go back to the program and we will try to understand this program, what we are doing here. Okay, let's do it in BlueJ. So here in BlueJ, let me create a new class and let's call it sum. Okay, or we can call it, because we already have a test class, so let's call it sum and let's say okay. Right, now we can double click or right click and open editor. And here, as I said, remove this code and we will write our own code. So just remove all the code except for the opening and the closing curly braces of the class. Now we will write public void and let's call this method as cal, followed by round brackets, open the curly braces. Now here we will write int a is equal to 2 comma b is equal to 3, and we will write int c, and then we will write c is equal to a plus b semicolon. See, after every statement I'm giving a semicolon, but not after the class name and not after the method name. Okay, and you can remove the public from here if you want. You can simply have it class. Okay, and now we are having system dot out dot println, or you can use print also. The sum is, close the double quotes, put the string concatenation operator, write C. So it will print the value of C, and now close the method. Save the class by pressing Ctrl S and then compile the code. Okay, so there are errors here. So what is the error here? Let us see what is the error. So it says identifier expected. So here, if you see, the spellings of public are wrong. So it needs to be corrected. PUBLIC. Okay, now we compile it. So there are no syntax errors. So basically what we are doing, let's first see the output here and then we will understand the code. So right click, new, sum, okay. And then right click, void, cal. Okay, now if you see, the sum is 5. So this is the output that we are getting. So let's go back to the editor and let's understand the output. So you see, the sum is 5. This is output. So what basically we are doing is, we are adding two numbers A and B. Okay, so when you're adding two numbers A and B, what it does is, we have to specify the data type of these variables. A and B are two variables. The value of A is 2, the value of B is 3, and we have to specify. In Java, you have to specify what type of data these variables will hold. So since these are integers, so we have to write int. Int is a data type in Java. Similarly, in C, we want the sum of A and B. So we have to write the formula C is equal to A plus B. But before we can use a variable, we must declare it. So this is called the declaration of the variables. So here we are declaring the variables, right? So these are single line comments, slash, slash, okay? So we are declaring the variables, right? You need not write this. So after that, I'm declaring another variable C, and then we are saying C is equal to A plus B, and then we want to print the sum. So we are writing the sum is C, right? Okay, and we can have another print statement here. We can have, if you want, you can print the values of A and B before you print the sum. So you can say, the sum of, close the double quotes, string concatenation, A, again string concatenation, then we have and, close, plus, B, plus, which is string concatenation, then we have is, string concatenation, close string, plus C. So what will this do? So let's see the difference in the two outputs. Okay, so now compile it again, and when you run it, new sum, okay, and void cal. Okay, so now we have the output window. So you see, we're getting a different output from the previous one. So what is this output? So see, here the output is the sum of whatever you write in double quotes is printed as it is. So we're getting the sum of, then this string concatenation. So after that, we have A, so it prints a value of A, which is 2. Then we print a string and, so it prints and. Then we have string concatenation followed by the variable name B, so it prints a value of B, which is 3. Then we have a string is, so it prints is, and then we have string concatenation operator plus, and then we have C, so it prints C, the value of C, which is 5. Whereas if you want to keep it simple, then simply you can write the sum is C. And there's another third way also, let me do that, which is even simpler. So instead of, you know, if you just want to print the value of C, so without any message also we can print it, simply print C. So it will just print the value of C. So when you compile it, now run it, right click, new, and right click, void cal. So now the output is C, 5. So the last print statement gives us this output because we're just printing the value of C. So now let's suppose instead of integers, we wanted the sum of two decimal numbers. So when we say, let's say 12.4, and here we say 3.5, okay, and I'm not changing the data type here. So when you compile it, so you're going to get error here, right? See, it is saying errors because the decimal numbers cannot be stored in an int data type, so we have to change it to double. Now double is a data type in which, double or float, in which we can store the decimal numbers. So D should be small, and again change the data type of C also to double. Now we should get the correct output. So let us compile it again, save it, Control S, compile it. So we are not getting any errors. Now we will run it, new sum, okay. Right click on this, void cal, and now we have this output. See, okay, let's open the editor window. Okay, so you see, now we are getting this output. So this is basically the concept of data types. That means before you can do any operation on any variable, you have to declare it and initialize it. Initializing a variable means giving it an initial value. So here the value of a is 12.4, the value of b is 3.4. So we are declaring as well as initializing, and we are declaring a third variable c, in which we are storing the sum of a and b, and then we are printing. Okay, so this is how we can print the sum of two variables in Java. Okay, so I hope you like the video, and thanks for watching eStudy.in, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel eStudy.in. Thank you.